Hey guys, Philip here, and today I'm showing you guys some advanced combos on Garchomp. My hat, I'm putting it on because I just got out of the shower. This is the third time I'm filming this video. The audio keeps getting messed up. I don't know why, but my hair looks all stupid right now, so I have that on for that reason. I've been playing a bunch of Garchomp since the game's release. The game's out for, I think, 3 days, and I have 111 games on Garchomp. 72% win rate. Sometimes I play solo, sometimes I play duos. My current rank is Veteran Class 1, but I usually play against players that are either Ultra or Master because I play with like a higher ranked team. Some of the people I deal with are like top 100, top 50. So we play against super good teams. So I think I know a thing or two about Garchomp. I've been playing him a bunch. And here's going to be the combos I'm going to be showing you guys today. I think I know like 95% of everything you have to know about Garchomp since I played him so much already. So I think I'm pretty good to give you guys some advice on this. Here's a look at the stuff I run. This is for bottom lane. If I was to go jungle, which I do sometimes, I would maybe switch out assault vest for something with more damage, like scope lens. But other than that, you could run this too, it'll be fine. So go ahead and lock this in. Always run eject button. I used to run X attack, but the higher and higher elo you go, you recognize that eject button is just best on like every character. In high elo games, 9 out of 10 people have eject button. And then you can just tell when you're in a low level game because everyone's running potion and stupid stuff like that. Just run eject button, get used to using it. It is super crucial, and I'll show you why in some of these combos because they require eject button. As Gibble, always start off with sand attack. Go ahead and sand attack this, and then just do this. Either you go bot or jungle, you always attack this one. So you get that. Sand attack. Okay, let's actually just start off with the abilities here. So first up, your passive. You see right under my health bar, there's like the little dots. You have it, once you have 5 stacks on Gibble, you do super crazy amounts of damage, have crazy attack speed, and heal on attack. So you always want to be fighting when you have 5 stacks. Because early game, you suck on Gibble. But if you have 5 stacks and you're continually autoing, no one beats you in any point in the game. I don't care what character you are. If you have 5 stacks on Gibble, Gibite, Garchomp, and you're auto-attacking people, and it's a 1v1 or whatever, and you're actually getting hits off, you will not lose. Even if you're like a level or two behind, you will usually win most battles if you play it properly. First up, sand attack after that. So yeah, that's your passive. 5 hits stacks it up. Your Bulldoze here gives you 1 stack, and sand attack gives you 1 stack. So this is important to keep in mind because sometimes you want to keep your stacks going. You want to always keep your stacks going when you're farming. So say I'm farming here, or sometimes have to use Bulldoze or sand attack to keep my clear going. By the way, when you're jungling, just don't Bulldoze. It just doesn't do any more damage. So you see I'm gonna drag this out a bit, and then I keep my stacks going here, and then I sand attack this to preserve my stacks. And sand attack gives you increased attack speed and move speed too to help you preserve your stacks. So I'm preserving my stacks, which is helping me clear really fast. See, I preserve my stacks the entire jungle clear, as you guys can see. And this is making me clear ridiculously quick. You know, you probably cannot bring your stacks to down here. If you eject button, I guess you can. Like, if for some reason, like, someone is stealing your camp down here, you can go ahead and eject button sand attack, and then preserve your stacks and fight them, and then get them off your stuff. So, sand attack. Sand attack's indicator is actually off. The indicator shows that it needs, like, to be, like, right there to hit. It is actually, like, super, super forgiving, sand attack's actual hitbox. You see here, it'll hit. Here, it'll probably hit as well, to be honest. See that? It still hits from all the way over here. It's clearly out of the indicator, but it will still hit. And it goes pretty far back. Yeah, it goes all the way back to right here, and also sideways too. It's pretty forgiving sideways. Like right there, it'll probably hit, no? All right, the sideways indicator is only a little bit off, but the forward indicator is really, really off. So you can use it like basically over its range. And this is important because like I said, sometimes you have 5 stacks. You wanna make sure to sand attack as early as possible to preserve your 5 stacks. And then sand attack gives you move speed only if you hit an enemy. So if you're running away and you sand attack, you don't get move speed. If you run away and you hit an enemy, you get the move speed. So make sure you hit an enemy if you're trying to run. Also, if you're trying to chase, again, hit an enemy. It gives you attack speed and move speed. It's very important for chasing and keeping up and preserving your auto attacks and your stacks. Bulldoze gives you a stack. I would never use it if you're fighting someone 1v1, never use Bulldoze. If you're fighting 2 people, it makes a little bit of sense to use Bulldoze. But Bulldoze is mainly meant to finish off targets that you can't auto anymore. So say like I'm autoing this guy and he's like running away. You see my auto attack range, right? And then he's going into goal and I know I can't catch him. I would auto attack then Bulldoze, like a quick little animation cancel here, because my auto attack will land and then once he's out of my auto range, boom, my Bulldoze hits. So yeah, you can auto attack Bulldoze. And then another combo of Bulldoze is doing eject button Bulldoze. So you can, I mean, you can Bulldoze eject button. You can Bulldoze and then eject button to cancel the animation of it. And this will make sure you drop your Bulldoze on your target. Very rarely do I use this. Only if like two people are low and then they're running away and they're about to get in the tower, I would go ahead and quick try a quick cheese kill there. But very rarely do you actually use Bodo's eject button. If you go the earthquake variant, then you use it a little bit more. You can also sand attack. You can also sand attack eject button like this. I don't think you save much time with sand attack one. The Bodo's one, I see merit for it, but the sand attack one, I guess if your chasing is good. Like, if you know they don't have the eject button and you want to chase someone down, like, you catch out someone in your jungle and then, you know that they don't have the eject button, you can just sand attack eject button and chase them down. So there's those combos there. Okay, let's go ahead and level up and show you Garchomp or Gible's best ability. Gible is, or Garchomp, whatever you want to call it, is super weak early game, all right? So your mission is to get to level 10 when you become a god, all right? And this is going to help you out. Dragon Rush has so many applications. This is what separates a good Garchomp from a bad Garchomp, okay? Most people know you can push with Dragon Rush, but you know you can pull as well, you know? So if someone is like aggressing on you here, you can pull them into your goal and fight them on your goal. And no one is gonna beat Garchomp on goal when he's stacked up, no one. You can also use it to help you secure neutrals. So you see, I can pull Audino under my thing, and and they have to overextend to try and steal it, you know? And since your early game is so bad, sometimes you need to do this to help secure some of your camps. You can also, if someone is playing really aggressive, if someone's playing really aggressive, you can go ahead and pull them into your tower too, like that, and then fight them under your tower. You can also use it with the eject button, like this. Oh, he actually ran out of range there, but like, oh, he's just full running, I can't get him. Okay, but you can combo with the eject button as well, basically. So if I don't get this forfeit, boom, I can flash eject button, and then I get him that way, you know? So, you can do that. Oh, I accidentally leveled Earthquake. Oh no, I should have leveled Dragonfall. Okay, I'll show you the Earthquake combos first because they're not really too useful. So yeah, there's Dragon Rush, super useful. And the hitbox, look how healthy the hitbox is, alright guys? It doesn't show, but he actually jumps behind a bit. See that? So even there, it'll pull probably even right here. And he even pulls on the side of it. The side hitbox is also really healthy. Like, see that? This is the one that side hitbox is really healthy, not sand attack. There you go. So this is super, super important. Another pro tip is Rotom. When you're doing Rotom top, sometimes you don't want them to secure it. So when it's about to die, you pull it into your side and you secure it on your side. If you somehow have it twice, you can pull it twice over here. If you're alone top and no one is gonna fight you for it, you can also push it over here and kill it on the enemy side so that Rotom pops faster. Rotom absolutely pops where he dies. So let me try it again. Stop running away. So he pops where he dies. So if I kill him over here, you see he pops right here. I can soar quicker, you know? So that's a quick little tip of Rotom there. Everything can get pushed by Dragon Rush other than Zapdos and other than Dreadnought. Those both cannot be pushed. Every single other thing can be pushed. The enemies can be pushed. Everything can be pushed other than that. So what I would recommend this is to start a team fight. If there's like three people group, you go ahead and eject button in and then you Dragon Rush them out into your team. Or maybe if they're under tower here, and you're trying to dive, you can actually inject, you can Dragon Rush them out of tower, and then Dragon Rush to push them even a little bit further back. I do not have Dragon Rush here, so I can't show you, but, yeah, so let me quickly show you the Earthquake combos. You can Dragon Rush, Earthquake as you land, and then the most important Earthquake combos, just like Bodo's, you Earthquake and then, Eject Button. So if you're walking someone down, and then they flash, you get Eject Button, boom, Earthquake, and it will slow and hit on that target. Earthquake gives you 3 stacks of your passive, by the way, because it hits 3 times. Right here. 1, 2, 3. And Earthquake helps you do, like, 2 camps at once, you know? Like, I do it with these Audinos a lot. So, like, right here, when I'm doing both of these, Earthquake or Bodo's, I use the last hit there. Man, you play with Rank 1 Garchomp right here, man. What are you doing, man? Rank 1 Garchomp with no cooldowns. Bro, get out of my lane. Alright, but there's Earthquake. And then another good thing about Earthquake is you can Earthquake ulti. So you can go ahead and do this, like that. And animation cancel your ulti and Earthquake. This gets really useful after you get Earthquake 2. Let's level up some more. After you get Earthquake 2, it slows. So you can go ahead and Earthquake and then ulti, and it'll slow everyone, and it makes them really hard for them to dodge your ult. If you guys play any Garchomp, you know his ult does a lot of damage. You play against Garchomp, you know his ult does a lot of damage. Dragon Rush, you can Dragon Rush and then slow him the second, you know, he jumps into your team, so it's a little bit hard for them to get out. But personally, I play Dragon Rush, Dragon Claw more. So, let me see, is there any more things I want to show you guys about Dragon Rush before I go? Actually, I'm not even going to show you anything about Dig. There's not much you can really do with Dig. I'll quickly leave the game here, and then we'll do, can I reset? I wish I had reset. All right, let's go ahead and leave the game here, and then I'll show you Dragon Claw. I go Dragon Rush, Dragon Claw, 99% of my games. Very niche cases, do you want Earthquake? I guess if you're going for a bruiserish maximum team fight build, you know, where your team comp, you know, you're not going to get ahead. You just want to play for, you only want to play for Zapdos. I guess Earthquake is probably a little bit better for the Zapdos fight than Dragon Claw. But I'm just so used to Dragon Claw because Dragon Claw is so good in lane too. And now I'm going to show you all the applications of Dragon Claw here. I'm way more experienced with Dragon Claw and Dragon Rush. So there's probably some animation cancels I don't know about Dig. And yeah, there's probably some animations I don't know about Dig and Earthquake. So you guys know, leave them in the comments. But let's go ahead and do Dragon Claw now. Alrighty. Practice settings. Okay, let's do Dragon Rush, Dragon Claw. Oh, my cooldowns. Okay, so Dragon Claw. First red and so first thing, Dragon Claw hits two times. It gives you two stacks of your passive. Hits twice, both times. First time pushes, and the second time just hits. So, as you see here, the first time pushes, and then the second time hits. So sometimes you're chasing an enemy, you don't actually want to, flash Dragon Claw like this, because you'll push him away. What you want to do is wait till your second part of it, then flash, and then hit your second part. Sometimes you don't want to push him away, you can do that. Or sometimes you do want to push him away, you can do that too. So Dragon Claw, first one pushes, second one hits. Keep that in mind, so you can do this. So you can do the first one, and then if you want to last hit someone, you use the second one like that. Because the second one does more damage as well. So first one, as you see, does five something. Second one does six something. So yeah, if you want last hit, always use the second one, and then you do that. If you want to push them away, you can go ahead and, I don't know, when you're saving a teammate, you flash in and then you Dragon Claw them away. You can also flash behind someone and Dragon Claw them away like that. If you want to push them into your team somehow and you don't have Dragon Rush, you can go ahead and push them into your team like that. But you definitely need definitely need eject button or else it doesn't work. You can also, if you're in close range, if you're near tower, you want to keep someone, I call tower goal tower. If you want to keep someone in your goal, you can do this. Like this, and you see another generous hitbox here, Dragon Claw, this will hit behind you probably. See that? So if they're running away from you in goal, instead of going ahead and Dragon Clawing them and pushing them out of your goal, you probably want to Dragon Claw backwards and keep them in your goal for as long as possible, right? So yeah, let me try this. So like say I Dragon Rush this guy in, I'm gonna just keep Dragon Rushing him in. You go ahead and instead of, you know, pushing them away, you push them into your goal like that. Yeah, yeah, you push them back. So you probably wanna do it like that. Also, you can chain Dragon Rush with Dragon Claw. But this will push you really far away. This is my combo for when I wanna get people out of tower. I wanna get people into my tower and help my team kill them. If I get people out of tower, I go ahead and I walk right up to them, right? Walk right up to them on the tower, I pretend like I'm scoring, and then I Dragon Rush them back into a Dragon Claw. Look how far away I push someone there. That is so useful when you have your jungler bot. You walk on the tower, pull them out, knock them out. They have to flash, and even if they flash, they're only going to be about here when their goal is over here, you know? So you have a lot of time to hit them there. So remember, use your generous hitbox on Dragon Rush to pull them out, and then go ahead and Dragon Claw them into your team. If you Dragon Claw mid Dragon Rush, it turns into a stun and guarantees it on whoever you Dragon Rush. So as you see, look, if I do Dragon Rush and Dragon Claw, it looks like this, right? But if I go Dragon Rush and I spam Dragon Claw, you see how I spin into the helicopter and I actually stun the target I hit. See that? I push him a little bit and then I stun them. I personally don't use this too much, but I guess if you want to last hit a target, it could be kind of useful. Yeah, if you want to last hit a target, it could be kind of useful to keep them stunned. If you want to make sure they don't eject button while you're pulling them, you can also do that too. So if I do this and I spam it, you see that? There's no way they can eject button out because they're stunned during the flight of it. So it guarantees that they're pulled the full distance. Whereas here, when you're getting dragged, I'm pretty sure you can eject button out. I'm not 1000% sure, But I'm pretty sure you can eject button now. So this way, there's no way they can eject button now, and you guarantee land your second part of your Dragon Claw, by the way, too. You guarantee land your full damage. So if you know they die to Dragon Rush plus Dragon Claw, you should always do this. Because it guarantees all the damage. It's undodgeable there. And again, it gives you 3 stacks. So yeah. Also, Dragon Claw, you auto-attack Dragon Claw. Did I talk about this yet? Auto-attack Dragon Claw, you can animation cancel. Auto-attack Dragon Claw, gives you 3 stacks. Your full burst combo is you Dragon Rush in, auto attack Dragon Claw, and boom, you have 4 stacks ready. So that's what you want to do for your burst combo. What else? So that is all the Dragon Rush combos I think I know. Just remember to use it to push away enemies. Again, it will also push away everything other than Zapdos and Dreadnought. So you push this back too. Look how far back you can push this, right? And then say no one is around. You can almost get this to score, by the way. Look at this. So say I'm doing this right now. I'm doing this. You can almost score immediately. Look at this. Ready? I kill this. I messed it up there by hitting the substitute with stupid auto-targeting, but you could have probably pushed it down to where this Apom is, and it walks in for 1 second, and you can immediately score. You cannot push or displace Dreadnought. This is important. Alright? So you can't push this or displace this. Yeah, keep this in mind. Let me see if I can flash out of this Dragon Rush. Come on, Dragon Rush me. Ay-yi-yi. He's not Dragon Rushing me, man. But I'm pretty sure you can flash out a Dragon Rush if you don't chain it with a stun. If you chain it with a stun, I know for sure you cannot flash out of it. You can also auto Dragon Claw into ulti like that. And this is probably your, like, if you have no stacks, this is probably what your combo is to start the fight. You just go in and you, here's your full combo. Your full combo, where's the dummy? I need to do it on the dummy. All right, if you have no stacks, where did the dummy go? Dummy's over here. If you have no stacks, your full combo is going to be Dragon Rush, auto Dragon Claw into ulti. Then you come out of ulti fully stacked and you start beating ass and you probably have Dragon Claw again. So that is most of the combos I know about Garchomp. General laning advice, make sure to secure your farm. Don't fight the enemy too hard. But if the enemy disrespects you and fights you when you're fully stacked in melee range, you will always win. You do not lose to anyone when you're fully stacked. Okay? Look how good of a fight he's putting up for being 3 levels behind. When you're fully stacked, that's super important. Also, you can do all of Vesper Quinn at once. You can go in the middle here, so it attacks AoE and kill them all at once. Which is nice. Yep, Audino, all this stuff you can pull towards your tower so that you can do it safer. Look how safe you can do this. If you're level 8, you can guarantee to secure all of these. You can push everything onto your side. Vesper Quinn is the most important thing to push on your side, by the way. This thing here. So say they're stronger than me and I can't fight them, or it's hard to secure, I just go ahead and do this. I push them back. Oh, I messed up there. But you know, I push them back, and then I Dragon Claw them in, and then I just secure it over here. And it's so OP, because they can't contest. If they contest, they have to walk up to over here, and they risk the jungler coming up to kill them. And if you're on comms, you can say, yo, I'm about to do Vesper Queen, okay? I'm pulling them into my side. And then they can't contest. You have your jungler hover. If they contest, they die. If they don't contest, you get Vesper Queen. So that is the power of Garchomp. Hope you guys enjoyed this video and learned something. Those are most of the combos I know. The one combo I didn't show, I guess I'll show it real quick here, is you can flash dig. It's not very important. Basically, you just flash as you're in the middle of dig animation, and then it extends your dig a little bit. Dig is good for making you tanky, but I personally prefer Dragon Rush. And dig is good versus melee. Dig is good to run away. But on Garchomp, unless you play wrong, never have to run away, alright? And there's no melee champion in the game right now I'm scared of. Later on, if they make a melee champion, I don't know, like Sizzle or something, that is just crazy 1v1 that Garchomp cannot beat, then maybe Dig would be useful for running away. But right now, you can just run away with Dragon Rush and drag them with you too, you know? The one thing bad about Dragon Rush is if you're running away, I guess you accidentally drag your enemy with you. You know, he can kill you or he can kill your teammates. But I think Dragon Rush is just so much better than Dig. Later on, if they create some more OP characters that you have to run away from, then I can see Dig being useful, but right now, you never have to run away. Dig does have the added benefit of Dig plus giving you damage reduction to make you even tankier, but I don't think it's important enough to gimp your laning phase by losing Dragon Rush. Dragon Rush helps your lane phase so much. So let's go ahead and do our stuff. We learned Dig this time. Let's go dig an earthquake, I guess. And no move cooldowns. So you can Dig here, as you see, it knocks up. And the good thing about Dig is, if you're running away, you see it doesn't pull an enemy with you. You know, like Dragon Rush, if I was running away like this, it would pull an enemy with me. And if I was one health, I wouldn't want that, right? So that's the one benefit of Dig. Dig does, like, briefly knock up. Like, it's the tiniest knockup, man. It has the tiniest knockup. I guess it gives you a little bit of CC if you're not running Dragon Claw. If you're running Dig Earthquake, it gives you a little bit of CC. So you can go ahead and do this and then Earthquake. Or maybe you go ahead and you go like this, flash Earthquake into Dig. And then you CC them on your Earthquake, so you guarantee they get hit by all of it. So I guess that could be kind of a good combo there. Like that. You see that? I dig to knock them up immediately so that they're stunned on my Earthquake. Maybe that could be useful. What else? You can flash Dig. That's the only other combo. You see that? You can extend your knockup if they run out of range of the eject button. You can follow the eject button and then knock up off Dig. That is really all I can think about with Dig. I don't see Dig being too useful. Maybe there's some crazy Dig combos with his ulti. Let's try it. I played like maybe 5 games of Dig. Every other game I played is with Dragon Rush. Let's go Dig plus Earthquake plus. Maybe there's some crazy combo with his ulti. Okay, it looks like you can animation cancel Dig and ult, which is kind of good. So you can go ahead and look at this. Oh, let's see. You can animation cancel a little bit as they're knocked up. You can guarantee the first hit. Let's see if you can guarantee the first hit of your ulti. It looks like you could guarantee the first hit of your ulti with Dig. Because it CCs them a bit, but I'm sure you can do the same with Dragon Rush and Dragon Claw if you use the CC version. Yeah, you could guarantee the first tick of your ulti. I guess that's kind of good, maybe. I don't know. I still would prefer... So full damage combo with this build would probably be something like, let me see. Something like this. Oh, I messed it up there. So you go... eject button. I messed up there. I didn't dig there. I need to earthquake, eject button, dig, ulti. Okay, so ready? I go... Earthquake, eject button, dig. Oh, I messed it up. Alright, so... Earthquake, eject button, dig, ulti. There you go. So I guess this is your full damage combo when you go this variation. So that's your full combo. Earthquake, eject button, dig, ulti. You hit all your earthquakes, you hit your dig, and you hit the first tick of your ulti. Actually, not too shabby. Actually, really not too shabby. Maybe I'll experiment with this a little bit more. I still feel Dragon Rush is super good in mid, like early to mid game to help you secure stuff and all that. But be kind of good. But yeah, that's a look at Garchomp and all the combos I know so far. I'm pretty sure that is most of the combos. There's not too much stuff I don't know, I think. I just noticed my cam is probably off the whole game, and you're like looking at half my face the whole game. My bad about that. Thank you guys all for watching. It's Phil from Youmuus here signing out. Hope you guys enjoyed and learned something. And thank you guys for watching all the way through. See you guys next time. Drop a like.